We're back at the Barnett Center in Aberdeen. The State A Wrestling Tournament getting set for 120. It'll be Tanner Bothwell from Sturgis, Nate Schaefer unbeaten against Brookings.
Bothwell, runner-up last year at 125. Nate Schaefer, injured last year, did not wrestle, but he was a runner-up, I believe, at 112 2 years ago. Again, some pretty physical kids here.
113-pound place.
And Schaefer, he likes to get down on that knee position.
He does. So quick. So quick. And Bothwell doing the right thing, a wider stance, keeping his hand down in the mat. Schaefer.
Bothwell 26-1.
Not much there.
Schaefer 21-0. Both guys cautious here early.
Yeah. When Nate was a kid, we had a hard time convincing him to be a wrestler, but finally it sunk in, and he's had a great career after that. Dave Korneman, another referee with a great high school state champion for the Gregory Gorillas and a national champion for South Dakota State on the head whistle. A minute left, no score. Both guys a little cautious, kind of feeling each other out in the face though now. Now there's some contact. Head to head, grinding heads. I think they're trying to get it figured out who's the strongest, and it's a tie. I think there's a lot of respect out there right now. Look back to the center. 35 seconds left. Schaefer.
He'll come up to his feet now. Now back down to that one knee.
Looking for an opening. You notice that every step he takes, he tries to work in a little closer, but Bothwell going the opposite way. And now a double warning by Dave Korneman. Both wrestlers warned for stalling. I think both coaches are wondering what the heck was that all about, but there wasn't a lot of action, and there hasn't been any scoring. So he's saying, you know, guys, I'm going to set the scene here. I expect you to wrestle. Coin flip, very important now, and Bothwell wins it.
Yep.
And he chooses down. Bothwell went 0-0. Good choice to go down. And away they go. Quick off the whistle, Bothwell. Wow, that was quick. I don't think it was 2 seconds, and Bothwell had the reversal. But Schaefer recovers, no danger, and Bothwell with a 2-0 lead. Whoa! Second slam of the evening.
We saw one in the
second slam of the evening.
Saw one in the wrestlebacks.
Absolutely not intentional at all. Just got up a little high. And again.
And
that one hurt. That one was on the head. That one hurt. That one hurt.
Now it's tied up at 2, and let's hope Schaefer can continue.
He's had some shoulder and some neck problems. The first one, neither one intentional, but the first one, Nate landed not on his head, but this one was right square on his head.
Don't forget, you can follow along on Twitter at SDPB Sports, and you can like us on Facebook, facebook.com/SD Sports.
Now he's got some recovery time.
Yep.
I'll tell you, the trend with trainers and doctors and everybody with these concussions, a head hit is way different, way different.
And of course, with concussions, what we've learned over the last few years,
right,
with the advancements in medicine, we've seen it with the National Football League, and people deservingly and rightfully taking
absolutely
a lot more serious.
And
that filters down to the college and the high school levels as well.
Again, Nate's hurt, and it is his head. And nobody wants to win this way. However, when it's ahead, it's probably not going to be the athlete or the coach's choice.
Well, the trainer staff, I believe it's from Avera Medical Group, they are here.
Uniform on the award stand.
They are tending to Nate Schaefer, a senior from Brookings, 21-0 on the season.
And he did. He landed right. And again, certainly not intentional on Bothwell's part at all. Just two big, strong kids. But the rules say, you know, you got to have a knee or something hit before your opponent does. And neither time that happened, at least what I saw. 30 seconds left in the recovery time for Schaefer.
I believe it was that Lindy that happened to?
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
From Lennox.
He was not able to continue. And he had had some injuries, too. Yeah. So. And again, in that one, nothing intentional, nothing mean-spirited, just good, hard competition. Nate's sitting up.
Coach Kessler standing by his man there, and you see him applauding as well.
Okay, now a decision has to be made. He's used his recovery time from the penalty point. Of course, Nate Schaefer, a two-time pole vault champion, already kind of on a fast track to a Division I school somewhere. He told me North Dakota State and South Dakota State both have approached him. Okay. Nate's down. Nate Schaefer down. Bothwell on top. 2-0.
And a standing ovation from the crowd for Nate Schaefer. Let's see if
absolutely
he can continue.
And Nate, he's coming up again. And he gets run right out of bounds. There's a technical violation. Absolutely. Absolutely. He ran him right out of bounds. No, that's it. And that's 2 points.
Things have gotten interesting.
And Nate Schaefer gets away.
Boy, things have picked up intensity. It was a little quiet in here during the first couple of matches. And they're trying to correct the scoreboard. It should be 4-2.
Schaefer.
4-2 Schaefer on top. We've got it correct on our screen. Now both men scoping each other out. Or check that 5-2 is
minute,
what they put up.
Minute 5 left. I don't think that's right, Bill.
I thought it was 4-2, but we'll check with the officials here in just a moment. The officials.
52 seconds left. Wrestlers are on their feet. Wow.
I'll tell you what, it is. This has been interesting.
Even that one, that's a tough call by the ref, but if the ref feels that Bothwell was directly running him out with not trying to keep him in, he has to call it. I don't know. I mean, it's exciting and trying to be a little neutral here, but.
Trying to put yourself in the referee's shoes,
and you have to
take advantage or take a look at it from their perspective.
I mean, but still, you got two tough kids here. Hard-nosed, tough kids. And they're going at it. 8 seconds. And I believe Schaefer will be down, right? Yeah, Bothwell chose down.
Yeah. And the period has expired. So now, well, they're gonna go in the standing position.
Well, they must. Bothwell, I don't think they. Coach Miller, it's.
Referee Korneman directs him back to the center of the
net. I think you people can probably hear we got the Sturgis fans right behind us.
And this is one of those things where you got a lot of the ESD fans are across the way. They're cheering for the kid from Brookings.
Yeah.
So you get the cross conference here.
Right. Minute 39. Now Nate's going to have to start working forward a little bit. Yep.
So
And now a point for Bockwell. Stalling on Schaefer.
5-3 now.
Yep. Holy smokes, what a war. What a war.
You can see both coaches in the background there on their feet. Now the referee will talk to both men.
5-3. Bothwell has to be careful. Oh, no, I think, well,
we're both
I don't know if there's another unsportsmanlike if he doesn't lose.
Could be.
Now Schaefer needs to take a shot. Okay. 58 seconds. Schaefer's got to do something.
We got the Sturgis fans right behind our broadcast location.
Schaefer
They're on their feet.
The ref's telling him. 48 seconds.
The Brookings fans, they're behind us to our right. The Sturgis fans are behind us to our left. Both those sections are on their feet. And you got some fans across the way also.
There's Schaefer's
up.
In. Schaefer's in. Now he's got to be careful. He's got to watch his head. Bothwell could throw him.
And they're stalling. Now it's 5-4.
Wow.
34 seconds and counting.
There. Turns. Oh, Bothwell with a takedown. Bothwell with a takedown. Unbelievable. He gets the legs in. What a match. 10 seconds. They're out of bounds. What? What a match.
Tanner Bothwell with the victory.
At this time, we would like to direct your attention to the awards.
We'll turn it over now.